Hi, thanks for joining us for another Velonomad.com product review. Today we're reviewing the Enviro Bike Box version 2. Before we do, I'm just going to quickly talk about version 1. Because it's important to talk about older versions of products so you can get a sense of how they've improved a new product. So version 1. Essentially a competitor cardboard bike box, but this is corrugated plastic, very, very light, quite large, big enough for a whole range of bikes. Added value with the straps to hold this thing together. This product kind of sits a little bit awkwardly in the constellation of bike bags or bike carriage for trips. On one end of the spectrum, you've got cardboard bike boxes, very cheap. $30 Australian. On the other end, you've got a Skicon, a Seacon Aero Comfort Evolution, the plastic hard one with hard case, which is very expensive. Now, this ostensibly is a competitor to a cardboard bike box, but instead of being $30, it used to be $100 Australian. So it always, for me, sat a little bit awkwardly. Same features as a bike box, very light, no wheels, although you can buy wheels with straps to put on these, which I'll talk about in a minute. You have to put extra protection in for your bike because you get a penetration to the side of cardboard or corrugated plastic in this case very easily. This thing packs down, so once you get overseas in a camper van or a hotel room, it can pack down. That's all cool. I mentioned maneuvering around airports. There's no wheels, so you need a trolley. Good for baggage handlers because it's got straps. Not much more I can say about that. Light, although, and like I said, all the same features of a bike box, cardboard bike box, but $99 Australian. So like I said, always sat for me a little awkwardly, which is why I'm a little bit interested in Enviro Bike Box number 2. So let's look at the Enviro Bike Box number 2, version 2 now. Now, this is how the box comes. You can see it's got these straps, which we'll talk about in a minute, holding the thing together. It's a bit of a jigsaw. I don't have a PhD in IKEA flat pack, although I feel like I should for this. I've had a good look at the instructions, and there are instructions, so I'm not wasting time putting this together. But before we put it together, here's a fast-forwarded video of me putting this thing together. We'll be right back. Enviro Bike Box version 2, I'll call it, review. Now this thing was incredibly frustrating to put together. Yes, I was on my deck in a little bit of wind, but it was so frustrating to wrangle the plastic that's not, like, it's pre-folded, but then you got to fold it more, and then you pop this bit in and that bit pops out, and the lids don't stay up properly. By the way, I ended up, even after reading the instructions, I've got the wrong size bottoms on. Enviro Bike Box, color code the tops and bottoms to the 1.4, the 1.6, 1.8, or print on them. Make it really easy to visualize which is which. Took me 20 minutes to put together. Yeah, the wind was a bit of a factor, but that, man, that was so frustrating. Take a breath and leave that aside. All right, so this product, now it's put together. Let's talk about the weight first. Very, very light because it's plastic. We've added this third-party product by Cubicle straps and casters on. Four straps come with the bike box. Getting around airports, so much easier. That is so light and so maneuverable. The bigger box size, up to 1.6 or 1.8 meters, you've got more straps. I could probably put another one on here now, but killer idea. These straps and the casters are a killer idea. Having said that, you could easily buy these separately from this because they sold on Amazon and other sites. Links down below. And use a airline cardboard box, which are 30 Australian dollars or whatever it is in the country you live in. And I know a few Velonomad readers, they do that. They get these straps and casters and they use them on plain old airline bike boxes. So make of that what you will. Having said that, these, they go together really well. These bits of plastic have got pre-cut slots for all these, so you can move them around. Protection for your bike. This version of the bike box, the old one didn't have this, but this version's got two layers of plastic, or two sheets of plastic on the sides and at the ends, which is good. It's better for the bike, less chance of penetration going through, but it still is plastic. It's not a good rip stop material like a bike bag. Having said that, you can put bubble wrap and stuff, or towels or whatever around your bike, which is what I normally do anyway, for extra protection for your bike. But just bear that in mind, this stuff isn't going to stop a really strong knock. I guess neither is a soft bike bag, but something like a hard clamshell will. The size, this is 1.4 meters long, so that should fit a normal road bike front wheel off, which goes in the supplied bike envelope. Cable ties go in the top, and that just slots in here. There's a couple of internal to secure the bike on the inside and protect it. You get two of these elastic things with Velcro. They stick on the Velcro on the inside and go around your bike. The instructions cover that. I'm not going to go through that. So that's quite handy to help secure your bike. Talked about the weight, talked about protection for the bike and the agility. So where this fits in the market, honestly, this product's not for me. It'll be for a lot of people, but for the price down below, or check their website for the latest price. For the price, I would either get the straps and go with an airline bike box. Some people do that, not for me. I much prefer to spend more money and get a bike bag like a Ski-Con or Sea-Con, however you want to say it. Aero Comfort TSA 3, version 4 when they release it and so on, or a BIC or Bike ND Helium or Jetpack, or an Evo C. For me, I prefer Sheikon products, but that's just me. So yeah, I mean, like I said, it's pretty simple. It's not the cheapest solution. You could, like I said, you get a bike box. That's why it fits in the market quite uncomfortably. You've got cheap airline bike boxes at one in the market, then you've got higher end products like the Evo C's and the Bic ND's, Bike ND's and the Sea-Cons at the other end. And this kind of sits uncomfortably, I don't know if that's the right word, in the middle. And it's not a cheap product for essentially the same features as a bike box. And it's not an expensive product with the same features as a bike bag. So I'm not quite sure what to make of it. Make of it what you will, but for me, I'd prefer to get a bike bag, but like I said, some other people would prefer this product. If you like what you see, it's worth checking out. It's quite flexible with the different sizes. Like I said, it packs nice and flat for when you're in a camper van or in a hotel room. If you like the video, subscribe up there. Next video up there. Comments, questions down below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.